I'm in the same place that I was when I came with my friend about almost a month ago, and we made a perimeter of fallen trees, and the perimeter is still here, as you can see. You see? On the camera it might look like the perimeter is a bit close, but no, I've got tons of space in here. And yeah, because, you know, I'm not in any, you know, in any private property where, or any farm or anything where I can be, where I feel safe at night. I mean, I'm rather far from civilization on the highway and that motorway, but yeah, I feel more comfortable when I have something like this. So at night, you really can't see anything much, even with the fire. It gives you just a meter or two, and I feel more comfortable when I have something that will let me know if anybody is coming too close to my camp. So, beautiful place, rather quiet, but I've been here before, and you've seen other videos of me here before, so I'm not gonna bore you with much. So I'm gonna be sleeping in that. Now, that is British Army issue net tent, mosquito net tent. So all that's going to give me is protection from any insects, I hope. Now, this I bought yesterday, and well, I say I bought, it was a present. You know who you are, and I'm very, very, very grateful for this little tent. I mean, I don't really like sleeping in tents, but this one I like. And of course, I'm going to be, let me see if I can, there we go. I'm going to be throwing a line, a ridge line over there, just over it. And I have a 3x3 meter tarp, which I'm just going to put on the back and then a bit to the front. So it gives me, you know, some protection from the wind and the rain. So, okay, I'll take you a bit closer to it and give you some closer shots. Okay, so let's have a look first of all at how it's held to the ground. It comes with four pegs. They go into this little plastic hook, then the actual bars, they go into the little rivet hole there, and it's stuck to the ground. Then there, it has these clips, see, these clips that just go on the bar to keep the netting straight. And then on the top it just has I've just noticed this might be to hang it up somewhere, I'm not really sure. But anyway, it's not really, oh, I see, this actually should go there, I reckon. So I've done it all wrong, innit? I know that this little strap goes around it, but I think it'll be okay anyway. Yeah, I think I should have put it, I don't know actually, it has only one, well, it's going to be alright, I reckon, I hope. It's the first time I even set this up. I just got it yesterday, and here I am trying it out. So it's got a little net inside, as you can see. Mosquitoes, damn it, getting all over me. I'm going to have to spray now myself, don't like doing that, but anyway, so it's got a little net inside, like a little bag or something to put, don't know what in there. It's got, now it's got a zip coming down here, and then on the sides, so it completely opens, makes it more comfortable. I'm sorry for the shaky camera, guys, but the mosquitoes are really getting into me. Okay, so it's got the three, so it opens up completely, and inside it's got little Velcro that sticks on the back and completely seals it off. So basically this is it, this is what I'm going to be sleeping in. Get rid of them pesky mosquitoes, I tell you, driving me nuts. Okay guys and girls, I always forget to mention girls, huh? Even though they are probably the most important thing in our lives. Anyway, right, so there's my camp ready. I've made a very I've done a very shoddy job of it with the tarp. The tarp was too big for the place that I found, and I didn't want to move because I already had everything else ready here. So I had to improvise a bit on the top, and as you can see, might not be the best configuration, but now I'm not expecting high winds or rain, though of course it might rain, but I'm not really expecting any, if you can actually believe the weather forecast. That's a joke, Anyway, right, it's taking me a long time to do this, so I didn't know how to configure it right. It's the first time I try such a type of shelter. I mean, yeah, I've done lean-tos, but this is a kind of lean-to with a tent and that, and I didn't know how best to do it. Well, we live and learn, yeah? Show you what I've done, though. I'm just going to take the camera off the tripod. Let me see, there we go. Okay. So, that's my top, which I think I've even put it inside out. But because it's waterproof, I hope it won't make much of a difference. Now, it was too wide for these two trees. So, I ended up folding it a bit. And this came out, this little pocket things, which I think if it rains I can use it to collect water, so that's not too bad. The same there, whoops, same here, and I have my little bag for rubbish there, which if it rains, of course, I'm gonna have to take it off. So let's get under the top a bit. Right, you see, looking at this, this is what is supposed to go hanging somewhere to hold the top from the middle. So yeah, I put it inside out, or the other way around, whatever. But I hope it won't matter much. Okay, so that's the tent. Let's go inside the tent, see what I've done. There we go. And open the side a bit. So what we have here is the sleeping bag that I showed you before. And below I have inflatable, self-inflatable, actually, or self-inflated mattress, which later I can, you know, blow into it and make it a bit thicker, which would of course be better. Then we have on that side, oops, sorry, the camera's going all funny on me. That's my pillow, yay! Yeah, I'm gonna sleep well tonight, I can tell you that. I'm gonna sleep well. Okay, so let's close this before I have all the jungle in here. Yeah, I must say, mosquitoes and the insects are driving me bananas today. I've sprayed myself a few times, but then, you know, I've been cutting wood and all that, and was sweating, so I suppose the sweat washed the spray away, and so I had to spray myself a few times. So anyway, I also brought, where is it, that little spiral thing against mosquitoes. Seems to be working well, because I have just one or two at the moment, so yeah. Then I prepared this little, very little pile of wood, but I mean, that's just to get it started, like tinder and that. And then I have that. That is what I've been, that's how I've spent most of my time for now, chopping all that. I've remembered the rule about firewood, so you should prepare as much firewood as you think necessary for the night, and then three times more. Now, this is very true when you are using pine wood. Pine wood burns well, but very quick. I keep saying it, and that's because it's the truth. It's something to know. Pine wood burns very quickly, and there's not really any other kind of wood around here. I could find some oak, but not nearby, and birch, but really nothing like that nearby. So that's my firewood for the night. Oh, I've just realized that I've left a log down there, which, down there, see if you can see it. I'm gonna have to go pick it up now. That's how I've done it on the back. I forgot my pegs, so I've had to use sticks. That's one. Improvised. That's another one, and etc. etc. So that's the view. Let me see. That's the view from the back. I said very shabby job. I've even left a bit open at the bottom, but again, I'm not really worried about the temperature tonight, just wind and I've just realized one thing. No, it looks like I put the top the right way, because this is what is used to, you know, to hold the top up from the middle. So yeah, at least I guessed with with which side of the top to use. Or rucksack. I'll probably put it here to block off the area where my head is going to be. My rucksack is waterproof, so if it rains or whatever, it should keep nice there. Okay, and oops, well, that's a tripod that I use. Very light. Yeah, I've used it. I've been using it for more than a year already. So, and that's what I use the other top for. You see, I can lay out all my stuff there. Though later, as it gets darker, I'll probably pack half of it away. I mean, things which I won't need in that during the night, and you know, so nothing gets lost. Okay, so at the moment it is, where is it? It is 25 to 7. Oops, it's lost focus a bit. And I still have about two and a half hours, maybe 3 hours of light. So now I'm going to rest a bit. Maybe I'm going to dig the fire pit. Yeah, actually I'll dig the fire pit first, then I'm going to rest a bit. So, Oh, look what I've just discovered. Quite a nifty idea. So when you saw off wood, sometimes it breaks into such a bit, you see, or you can actually break it on purpose if you need to. And so when you get a few of them, you stick that part on the ground and just hammer it in. You make yourself a kind of table, actually, though this one is a bit taller than the other two, but I think you get the idea. This one's not going to go any deeper. Oh, actually it did go deeper. So now I have a little table. Rather sturdy, it's not going to go anywhere because it's got them bits in the ground. And then you can use your table for firewood. Anyway, just thought I would show that, just thought of it right now. There we go. I'm preparing dinner. Nothing fancy, just some dried pasta. I'm boiling some pasta now. And yeah, just wanted to show you the table. Oh yeah, and I did bring my gas stove. As I think I said before, that it's very useful for when you're just walking. You stop, you can make yourself a coffee, you know, no need to light a fire. And also, I mentioned it already, the firewood I have is for the night time, for when I think that there is a risk of any boar charging in. So I need my fire at least for most of the night. So the table is working though. Stable, not moving, not going anywhere. Okay. Well, guys and ladies, it's getting dark now, and it's 9:15, and I still have a bit of light left, but it's already dying. So while it's still not dark, I wanted to show you some of the, well, some, I have three torches that I always, or flashlights that I always take with me. First of all, I think I showed this one before, cheap one, goes on your forehead, kind of, like that. Now this one, I use, it's the one I use the most often. So it's got three, it's got a low light, it's got a much stronger light, even stronger, so the maximum, then it's got flashing and then off. I don't know what the flashing light is for, maybe to signal for help or something. No idea, never used it actually, and if it's to signal for help, I'm glad I never had to use it. Okay, well, then I have this one. Oh, the mosquitoes are killing me. Actually, smoking helps, is good for something at least, and that is kind of keeps them away a bit. So anyway, because of the smoke, I imagine, yeah, logically. So I can't find the make of this. The make of this flashlight, and it doesn't really matter. It uses three AAA batteries, like actually the one on the forehead also uses three, and it's got, yeah, it's rather powerful, I would say. This is the one I use if I hear any strange noises or something at night. And then I have the last one, is this one. Actually, yeah, including this one, all three I bought last year, and I've used them a lot, and they still work perfectly. Thanks God, actually. So anyway, what this is a crank. Let me see if I can get this closer. It's a crank flashlight, torch, and yeah, it has only one setting. Oops, lost the focus there. So, about this. This I usually hang on the ridge line of my lean-to. Tonight I'm going to be hanging it on that little pocket thing that I showed you, and actually you can still see there. Oops, there. So I'm going to hang it there, and what I wanted to say is I've cranked this up for 1 minute. Not very fast, you know, just regular. So regular, like this, yeah, regular speed. So I've cranked it up for 1 minute, and I turned it on, left it on, and it worked for, I think it was an hour 15, an hour 20 minutes, and then I turned it off because I got bored. So it lasts a long time. This one is just to brighten up the area where I'm sleeping, if necessary. And it's got a little compass. Don't know if you'll be able to see that. It's got a little compass there, which is basically, which in my opinion is basically worthless. I have another compass with me. I don't know if this one even shows properly or not, to be honest. I think it's even stuck. But that's not important. The important thing is that as a flashlight, as a torch, it works fantastically, and yeah, really happy with it. So it's getting dark now, and the mosquitoes are driving me crazy. One of them even went into my eye, and I've got contact lenses. But you know, I have my container with me and the liquid and all that, and I had to take the lens off. Well, actually clean my hands, take the lens off. Clean my eye inside. cool experience. Yeah, so I'm gonna be starting the fire. I know that if I had started my fire earlier, I wouldn't have such a problem with mosquitoes now. I know that. So you're all probably, why haven't you started your fire already? I know. But again, I'm keeping the firewood I have for the night. And that is my main priority. So I'll probably come back when the fire is lit, which is going to be, I reckon, any time now, because the sun has gone way below the tree line. And yeah, I don't know how much light I have left. Not much, I imagine. So I'll come back with the fire then. Well, got my fire lit. You can see the reflection from it. Beautiful. It's nice and easy because everything is dry. And I have plenty of firewood, I hope. So yeah, changed my clothes also, because my t-shirt was absolutely wet, and we all know that you shouldn't go to bed with wet clothes, hypothermia and the like. So I had dinner also. I didn't show you that because it wasn't that interesting. I had my typical pasta with tinned meat, beef. Well, yeah, there's no point in filming at night, and it is rather dark already. 20 to 10, though I still have a bit of light left. Not much, I imagine. So yeah, no point in filming at night, and since I've had my dinner, and I'm very tired. Walked a lot in the heat and worked a lot, preparing all the firewood and that, so I think I'm gonna wait a while longer and go to sleep. If the mosquitoes leave me alone. I have the mosquito net tent, which actually my setting for tonight looks like a 5-star hotel. Well, that's it for tonight then. I'll be back in the morning. Good night then all. God bless. And catch you tomorrow.